This is the to be continued
from last movie. Yeah.
Okay, a quickly catch up from where we are in the last movie. We are at Stord. I'm with my buddy Nico. He's been looking at boats. I'm there to pick up a crashed sprinter boat, high and long, huge car. I have the sprinter and trailer from Olav Antonsen. It's no winch on the trailer. The guys who was there where the sprinter was parked told me they should help me get it on. They had to go away, no one to help us. So I was actually a little bit lost there. But luckily, Nico found a solution. So then, let's roll movie.
First of all, now I'm gonna need some tools.
This Olav is having here. Alright guys, look at this. Dino sticker on the toolbox. That's cool, that's an old go-kart. How to say this? Nico did run away now. I was thinking, where the fuck did he go? He organized this.
Is that the help?
That's the help. All the turtle tools.
Holy shit, the digger.
This is just unbelievable. A huge digger Nico got, eh?
It's on.
Okay, that was Håkon.
Nico! Where did you find this guy?
Over there?
That saved us for so much work, eh? We probably could manage it without him.
Now you're at Battle of Steel. Olav, I'm sorry, but you have to cut away some bolts to get this light up. We cannot drive home like that. Bolts are going up.
So then.
The light is fixed. Now we can go back home.
Yes, we are back in business.
I don't know if you're back in business, but we're on the way back home, yeah? Only 9 hours. And it's gonna be really exciting with the huge sprinter on the back. Especially down the mountain on the other side. I hope Olav have good brakes on this sprinter. Look at this place. It's beautiful, eh? Unbelievably nice it is.
I'm checking off the strops, though. I'm very good, Nico.
I have checked it, yeah.
You're standing there in the sun, just relaxing.
Good.
Look at this view, guys.
I actually feel I've been talking a lot about the view this movie now, but sorry, I can't.
I'm the new movie.
I just think Norway is really beautiful. Nico. Take the phone and make movie out the window back there. That was really beautiful there. Show the people the nature.
Here you can see this mountain.
Yeah, small and stuff.
And here is more mountain.
Can you see the water over
there? Here is the water also, yes.
Ah, beautiful. Yeah. Sun and water and snow. Stav og kø. Traffic. Kolonnekjøring, sier man på norsk. So we actually be driving from 4 o'clock this morning, and now is it almost 7? That's 15 hours.
15 hours, yeah.
And we still have 5 to go, Nico.
5?
Yeah, it's far home.
Yeah.
Oh, what do you have there, Mr. Stian?
I have a box with vegetables, gulrøtter and broccoli, ris, kylling and bearnaisesauce. That's a perfect dinner when you're out traveling.
That look perfectly very nice.
This is going to be a really bad vlog. Yeah, Nico, it's now 11:30 in the evening. We've been pushing really hard now because we wanted to manage to catch the last ferry, and looks like we're going to do it.
Yes, there's the ferry.
And one thing was great with using the car to Olav. You get this autopass, so let me just go for autopass here.
Yes, green light. Thank you, Olav.
Thank you, Olav. Good luck! Good luck! We are soon in Moss. Then we only have a 30 minutes more to drive, then we're back home. Then it's gonna be 1 o'clock in the morning. That means when you're back home, we've been driving for 21 hours, Nico?
Yeah. That's right, that's a long trip.
Yeah, it's an okay one.
Hallelujah, we made it.
We made it.
Thanks for a nice trip. It was nice to have you with. You look tired, Nico.
Home, guys. 15 past one. Over and out. Holy shit, it's the next day. I had my alarm on 7 this morning. I wake up and I thought, oh great, I'm before the alarm because I didn't hear anything. I haven't heard anything because it was 9:30 when I wake up. Then we have rolled off the sprinter. Now I'm gonna fix the lamp there. We cut off the bolt yesterday. This is up here now. I've now been cleaning the sprinter tool up for as a small thanks for borrowing it. I have been 4 different places here now in my town picking up stuff, but now I go to Oslo to Proffkle, my sponsor, then I go down to Olav in Tønsberg and deliver the car. Parkering forbudt, ja. I have to, sorry, I don't have any other place to park.
Let's see if we can find Thomas. I have some suits for him.
Hello?
Hello?
Delivery?
Oh, nice.
Hey guys, to all my Norwegian followers, skal dere ha arbeidstøy? Det det her godteributikk. Her får du tak I alt på Proffkle. Hovedsakelig blåkleder, det det jeg vil du skal handle. Men de har også Helly Hansen for dere som ikke helt fornuftig. Så putter en link her nede. De kan også ordne alt med trykk, sende rundt hele Norge, bestille online. Ja, den butikken her overleggende gjelder for å ta arbeidstøy. Så sjekk linken under, og så hvis dere skal ha noe rabatt, så kontakter dere meg på en eller annen måte, så ordner vi det. Thomas har allerede been eating 4 pieces, and he said no more, he said, eh? No, I'm pausing here, and he took one more. Difficult to stop, eh? Got from Thomas now some gloves, 2 packages with gloves, with Proffkle gloves. How cool is that? So then, now I'm ready, now I go down to Olav. I don't know how far it is actually, because now it's going to be a lot of traffic out of Oslo. Welcome to rush hour in Oslo. I thought we're going to use 45 minutes down to Olav. GPS shows me 2 hours.
I am back in the timber world.
Olav, I am really impressed with your workshop bench.
Oh, it's really nice.
Huh?
To have some tools spread around.
Hey guys, I just want to show you Olav's place from this side. It's unbelievable. I love this place actually. I really wish I get a place like this on my own one day when I grow up.
The dogs are away now, so you can come.
Yeah, come on.
Hello.
Olav just showed me here now on the timber wolf here. He have his own patent on this winch, and he actually sold now just one to UK, he sold one to Belgium, he's selling now, starting to sell all over the world. Start to be international, Olav, selling all over the world.
Yeah, we have some, we are lazy in Norway, you know, we need to be do things really without any power, so this is the remote controlled winch.
So the winch is controlled by the remote.
Yeah. So that's unfeasible, you just winch them up.
That's for lazy guys, yeah, for sure.
So the trees are coming up here, you know, and landing here, and
that's great.
That's great.
So the winch here then is really helpful when you're gonna drag huge trees.
Yeah.
Carry it down.
Yeah, because you know this one can chip big trees and they are heavy to lift, so you just winch them up here and land them here, and then if they're really heavy, you can back the chipper back, and then the feed rollers can take the rest of the job and put it into the chipper.
Pretty awesome.
I promise you guys, one day I'm gonna get one of these huge wood pieces from Olav, make myself a really cool table.
So today morning, we're gonna go roller skiers here now at this ski arena.
Here we have Simon. Hello, Simon.
Hello.
Hello, Jarle. Jarle,
you're killing me.
Can you explain me how it went today?
Well, I actually got beaten by Stian on the last 2 intervals.
You got beaten by Stian?
Well,
that's music in my ears.
It's home and workout.
Yeah, you have to go home and work out for a few months, and you can call me then when you've been practicing.
Here's the boys coming. They're doing intervals. We are done. Or me, I and y'all is done, because y'all had to go a little bit early today, so we started half an hour earlier than the guys here. So when Dan arrived, he was already done with four. So that's why I'm sitting here looking now.
It's a special offer on smoothie. You're at menu. Morten!
Hello.
See what I fick tak I?
Riktig.
Special offer on smoothie. It's 50 bottles.
Riktig.
Det snadder.
Ja, har vi nok for I dag I hvert fall.
Klarer du ikke å ta det nå? I have actually forgotten this project a little bit last days, but I have to pack down all this till I share now. Yeah, I'm gonna do it now in the very skier. In the car, I have some nice stuff from Blocko. Oh, that's a piston for my go-kart. And I have winter gloves and welding gloves from Blocko. That's nice. You can hear, it's something crazy outside, yeah. It's this ball bag, eh? Faen, for a fet lyd der igjen.
Helt syk, syk lyd.
Og den helt rå.
How is it going, Jan-Erik? How is it going with the books?
It's going very good.
Very good?
Very good. Beyond good.
That's absolutely great. Then you are here, I'm down here.
No.
Here it's going hard, it's difficult and hard.
You have a black car and I have a
blue. I actually gonna tell a story now, because on the way to work here now, I see this ball bag is coming in the mirror. I have my mother's car. And it's two lines. He's coming on the inside with a girl. I just quickly pull over and block him, you know, he's coming faster. So he had to brake. And I just give him a little bit of space and then he went through full throttle. And he didn't know it on me, so I called him. And then he said, he told the girl when he passed me, you think this is a special BMW, special edition, because it only has one exhaust. You didn't know they made those, he said. Because this ball bag have an M with four.
That's actually ridiculous stupid to say.
It's funny.
It's really funny. Jeg blir playboy. Hæ?
Smeller litt.
Ja, gikk du? Brekast eller?
Litt efter smeller litt.
I'm now at my buddy's farm, Thomas Hauge, but he was in my video a few times. He was in the last one. He was the guy in the screw tresker out on the land there when I was running. I actually feel a little bit bad because I brought him now two times in my video and I always say he's a farmer, you know? But Thomas, he's a real hard, great racing car driver also, you know? He was doing go-kart with me when he was younger. Then he did this Chrysler Neon in car racing. He won almost everything he competed in. And he did a huge Corvette later on in tarmac racing, like I do, the Norwegian Championship he did. But now he do like his father is doing, drag racing. His father, back in the days, did really good in drag racing. He was driving with Ford, and he was actually in front of the Ford factory in developing the engine and stuff. So he's a hard guy. Thomas is following his footsteps now with drag racing.
Hello?
Hello.
This is Thomas's car. Actually, this car we was working on down in the basement on a neighbor farm. When I was 17, you was 18 or something, 20, 19. That's many years ago.
Ish.
Then this car was a piece of crap. Now it's a proper race car.
Fast piece of crap.
Fast piece of crap. Yeah.
I think we're gonna end the vlog here actually. Thanks for watching, and if you already didn't, please subscribe to my channel. It's going slowly upward, I appreciate it. New video is soon ready, again actually. I'm in a good flow these days. So here's actually what you're gonna see in the next one. Well, more of that is coming in the next one. So, see you guys soon, eh?